Oh dear. Hello. Oh, hello, Uncle. Yes. Really? Oh, well, we were trying, yes. Oh, yes. Yeah. No, I know. Yeah. Melvin? Oh, okay, yes. He's here. Hold on one second. Hold on.
Hi, Gov. Yeah. All right. Make eye contact. Yeah. Yeah. Clear questions. All right. Yeah, I will, and get out of the slammer, okay? All right, thanks, Gov. All right, bye.
Oh, what did he say?
He said, that rabbit needs a slap. Do I want to do it?
Oh.
Come here, you little...
No, Melvin, you can't do that!
Only on Blue Peter, I meet a boy who has his own jungle playground.
Forget carving pumpkins, Zoe and I race them, and I fear the fear of fire.
It's Halloween and time to overcome your fears. So we thought we'd heat things up a little.
Oh yeah, check out those fiery moves. That there is Shana Rose and she is highly trained and extremely professional, I'm sure you'll agree. Now the reason why Shana is not getting burned is because of the speed at which she is twisting her hoop and also her protective armband. But whatever you do, do not try that at home because you will not be so lucky and you might get burned.
Yeah,
not
for
good.
Sure, for sure. Well, I think it's fair to say this is heating things up a little for a bit later on. So I think it's time you tell these viewers what Zoe's going to be doing.
It's not a bad plan. It is not a bad plan. And this is something scary indeed. Forget your Halloween ghosts and ghouls. Mm-hmm. You're not going to be spinning fire like Shana did, but fire is involved, Zoe. Now, I have already done this before, so let's have a look at what happened when I tried my luck.
Keep going.
I feel really weird. I just feel really weird, like my fingers are tingling. Okay. On the last steps, I could feel it burning my feet. I'm sure I could. I'm shaking. Oh, it all comes flooding back. That was what happened when I walked on hot coals. Zoe is similarly going to be walking across this fire later on in today's show. How are you feeling at the moment, Zoe?
Very hot, stood beside it, so yeah. I can't imagine how hot my feet are actually going to feel once I go along it. Scary. But you're here, you did it, you're still alive, so I'm feeling confident
okay.
I'm going to survive it, which is always a good thing.
I am here to tell the tale, but don't worry, you're not just in my capable hands, because over here we have got top firewalking expert Martin Sterling.
Hey, always good to have you on board.
Thank you for inviting me.
I don't think there's many of you guys in town usually, but
no, that's right.
Tell me, Martin, what are you and your team up to at the moment?
As you can see, my team are here building the fire to the correct specification, making sure it all burns down at an even rate. Mm-hmm. It's going to be something beautiful to walk on.
I love that, mate. So how far are we going to make Zoe walk today?
Going to go 6 metres, which is about eight paces. Eight paces meant to end. Bare flesh.
Okay.
No special lotions or anything on her feet.
Eight steps, that's not a lot, is it?
And easy for you to throw.
It doesn't sound a lot when you're walking, does it?
All right, fair enough. So tell me, how hot is this going to get?
Well, goodness me. Well, let's just measure this with a gauge here.
Okay. So what are we on there?
He's just gauging it. Get it?
At the moment here, it's going straight up.
Come on, don't keep us in suspense.
About 409 degrees centigrade.
Yeah,
exactly. So more importantly, how hot does flesh burn?
Flesh burns at 149 degrees centigrade.
So it's going to burn three times more than it normally would.
Right, okay. Fair enough, mate. Right, so tell me, where does the art of firewalking come from? Enlighten me.
You will find firewalking on pretty much every continent on Earth.
Right.
The history of firewalk precedes recorded time.
Mm-hmm.
I myself learnt this in India, actually in Rajasthan, and I saw people over there performing it as some sort of ceremony.
Okay.
And it's been used as a rite of passage, as a ceremony, as a test of manhood.
Oh, brilliant.
On many, many different
levels. Test of womanhood today!
A test of womanhood.
It's something for everyone. Great stuff. Okay, so What have you and Zoe done to prepare her for this today?
We've trained on two different levels.
Right.
The first thing is mentally. Sure. I've been working with Zoe to get her to focus on how good is she going to feel after she's walked on hot coals. Mm. It's so easy to focus on how you feel at the moment, and if all she did was that, she'd focus on how scared she is.
For sure.
Yeah. We've also done some physical training as well.
Oh, are you feeling scared? How are you feeling?
Well, you know, I'm getting into that zone where it is mind over matter. So I've got to say that I'm feeling confident. I'm going to do it. I'm picturing myself over that line.
Nice. Well, you've conquered your fear of horses on the show.
Yeah.
You've got a fear of speed. How is this going to compare to all of that?
Well, you know, there is that age-old thing, you know, don't play with fire. Well, I'm going to be doing more than that. I'm going to be walking along it. So that's pretty weird. But I'm feeling confident. I want to do it. You've done it.
Mm-hmm.
I want to do it too.
Okay, well, you will do it. Not just yet, because we've got to prepare the fire.
Yeah.
And we've got to prepare you. But in the meantime, how'd you fancy looking at some big pumpkins?
Love pumpkins, especially large ones. The bigger, the better.
Gardening, such a relaxing, peaceful hobby.
Think again. These guys are the extreme pumpkin growers, and they like to grow things extremely large. And for Halloween, they like to go extreme pumpkin boat racing.
Hello, Ian. Lovely to meet you and your pumpkin. I can't believe how big it is. How on earth did you get it that big?
Well, we started off with just one seed about that big. And believe it or not, this is only one plant from that seed. To start with, it grew from this little tiny baby, and in 100 days, it's got to this size. It's not unusual to grow at 50 pounds a day.
And now you're going to turn it into a boat?
We've just got to cut the pumpkin off and make sure it's OK underneath.
So if it's bad, no boat?
No boat.
It's cut. I've done the data. Let's check out the underside now.
Big heavy job. Ian, how's it looking on the underside? Is the race on?
It looks absolutely fine.
Brilliant. Get that pumpkin onto the trailer and let's get it out of here.
Oh, that's heavy.
These giant pumpkins, which are in fact fruit, get so big because they're fed 100 litres of water a day. But the real secret is the seeds, which come from other giant pumpkins, and Ian wanted to see if his one was a record breaker.
What is the current record at the minute?
Current record, 1,124 pounds.
OK, and that, of course, is held by you!
Myself and my brother Stewie, yeah.
Well, let's just sit here and keep our pumpkin company. Don't be nervous, it'll be fine.
It was time to weigh our baby.
Tension's mounting.
I've got no nails left.
But disaster struck.
I think it might be too heavy for the scales, guys.
The scales are going, Will we be able to weigh the pumpkin, will we not? It's a bit of a cliffhanger. It's a pumpkin hanger.
So heavy, it's actually broken the scales. So we're not actually going to be able to weigh it today.
I don't believe it. What are the chances of that happening? But at least the boat race is still on. Can I borrow one of your other pumpkins?
Of course you can.
Great, because I want to turn this into a real race, and I've got someone that I would love to race against. I'm going to give them a call.
I give Konnie the shock of her life.
Oh, my word.
While pumpkin racing proves more tricky than a treat.
Oh, yes, stay tuned for the great pumpkin race. Mm-hmm. Are you excited, Martin?
Hopefully it's written all over my face.
It is.
Well, I'll tell you what, Martin, earlier when we measured this wood, it was at 409 degrees centigrade, and then it got cooler. What stage is it at now?
We've got this incandescent wood embers. Ooh, we're going to be ready to walk on some fire.
OK, so tell me, what does wood usually burn at?
449 degrees centigrade.
And the glorious flesh?
The glorious flesh burns at 149 degrees.
Oh, so I'll get three times more burnt than I normally would.
Yeah. But it's okay. All good. All right, tell me, then let's get into a bit of science, yeah?
OK.
How come Zoe can walk over this and her feet won't be burnt?
Good point.
Yeah, well, very much in the same way. If you had a hot jacket potato, you could pass it from hand to hand and neither hand would get too hot because the hot object's going from side to side. Same with Zoe's feet when she walks on this. Because she's not standing still on hot coals, one foot at a time.
So she's not in one position long enough to really burn her
feet.
That's
right.
Keep moving, Zoe, keep moving.
Don't stand still.
Okay, but you know, it's all fair saying all this, but surely you need to believe in yourself. How do you get a normal person like Zoe into the right state of mind to walk across a hotbed of fire?
The training that Zoe and I did earlier on wasn't about believing, it's about knowing.
Okay.
Yeah, put her in a state of mind where she knows when she's at this end exactly how good she's going to feel when she's at that end.
Oh, nice.
I totally dig. Starts to run up in knowing.
In my head, I've done it.
I totally dig everything you're saying there. Right, you've got 10 minutes left.
Okay.
Any final bits of preparation for Zoe?
A few little bits that we did yesterday.
Okay.
Okay, show me how you're going to stand. Show me how you're going to breathe. What kind of look are you going to have on your face? And you know already how you're going to feel when you're there. And don't forget to count with every single step because that makes sure that she's breathing.
Okay, here we go.
Walk forward, go.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then I've done it!
That's right, absolutely.
Okay, so we've got to go something a little bit like that, but without the welly bit.
So what does she keep need to doing? Does she need to keep her blood flowing, adrenaline? What does she need?
Adrenaline flow is important, not to stand still, otherwise she'll start to feel scared to breathe, because when you're moving around and you're excited, you've got to breathe correctly. And she's also got to keep looking at where she's going, not what she's got to walk through. The rules of fire walking are the same as those of tightrope walking. Don't look down.
Love that. Well, keep focused, Zoe. Okay, right now, we're going to go to our final adventure from Bolivia. I know, don't worry about it. It warms my heart too on this cold evening. But this is about a boy who has a playground in his back garden, but his back garden is deep in the Bolivian jungle.
Nice.
I have come to Bolivia's coolest adventure playground.
Woo-hoo-hoo!
Now, this is what I call travelling with style.
And it all belongs to 12-year-old Glader and his family.
Hola, mi amigo. ¿Cómo estás? How are you, Glader? Do you mind if I jump on? Gracias. Dude, this is one of the coolest places I've been to in a while. How did it all begin?
It started off when I was 3 years old, when my dad built this plane for me and my sister. Since then, it's grown into a full-size park for everyone.
Un parque entero. Es grande.
I'm glad to hear adults can come as well. This place is immense. Wait, you didn't tell me it was this high.
Glader has helped his dad build everything here. The main attraction is the swings, which are about as tall as houses.
Right, here goes. After three. Yeah. Uno, dos, tres. Woohoo! Hello! Mate, this is fantastic! So, what do your friends think of this, your amigos?
My friends all love it here. They come all the time, especially in the evenings.
Well, I must say, if this was my friend's back garden, I'd be here all the time.
And talking of friends, one of Glader's mates has popped round to see him.
Oh, Glader, ¿es tu amigo?
Sí, es mi amigo Franz.
Ah, Franz.
Hola, ¿cómo estás?
¿Cómo estás? Muy bien. I see why Glader's mates love coming over. Even the bedrooms are up in the trees. I love this house, I must say. Oh, I tell you what, the surprises just keep on coming. This bed is pretty funky. So what would you like to be when you're older?
Turístico.
Oh, you like to be a tour guide. So do you learn English? ¿Aprendes inglés?
Yes.
Yes, you're good. ¿Cómo es mi español? How's my Spanish?
Good.
Good? Wow, okay, you're good, you're good. So what kind of English do you know then?
My name is Glader. I am your guide.
My name is Glader, I'm your guide. You're well on your way, loving that.
It's no surprise they get lots of visitors here, and Glader earns pocket money by selling jewellery made from nuts and seeds he collects from the jungle floor.
Oh. ¿Estás?
Sí, sí.
Perfect. What is the best thing about living in the jungle?
La tranquilidad porque en la ciudad hay mucha bulla y aquí es más tranquilo.
The peace and tranquility, that is totally different to where I'm from. I am liking this display. Have you got the seeds? Thanks, Franz. Look at this. We go from that to that. I think I get some for the guys. And I'll go for that one. Dude, how amazing are these?
They're cool. Imported all the way from Bolivia.
But you know what?
It's really sad, because that was the last of our Bolivia films.
No.
This reminds me of being in the Bolivian jungle by the campfire.
It does.
We had some great times. Mm. Yeah, you know, the wrestling was good.
Football at Tawichi. Oh,
we saw so much, Lake Titicaca. What was your best and worst bit?
And well, obviously the jungle was a huge highlight for me.
Amazing.
But what I didn't like about the jungle were the two bites I picked up, yeah?
Oh, listen to this. This is a good story, everyone.
Right, okay. Yeah. So we come back from the jungle. I've got these two bites on my back, and we're on this filming trip, yeah?
Yeah.
So
this is like 2 months later.
Yeah, obviously,
after we're back
7 weeks. Yeah.
Yeah.
So I look on my back, and I look at one of the bites, and something starts peering out of one of the bites.
No way.
Yeah. So I squeezed it, and this larvae pops out on the floor. I'm squealing like that.
Gross.
So check this out. This is what came out.
Oh, it's like having an alien life form emerge from your own body.
Dude, I didn't dig it at all. So anyway, I go to the doctors and they had to sort of do an emergency operation to get the other one out of my back.
Oh my gosh.
Later on, we find out this is the human warble fly, yeah?
Oh, the human warble fly. Dermatobia hominis.
You know it, man.
Parasites native to South and Central America.
Monster, you are on it.
They live off human flesh.
They do. So basically, what they do is they lay their eggs on mosquitoes and other flies, so they're the carriers.
Right.
Once the mosquito bites you, the eggs feel the warmth of your body and crack and literally embed themselves there for as long as they need to find their way out, land in the ground, and then blossom into lovely flies. So, yeah.
You had no idea that they were living in your body, in your back?
No, not at all. I was habiting these evil spirits.
Oh, that is such a horrible Halloween story. You keep your horrible parasitic larvae in that little jar. And in the meantime, I think we should see whether we made it over the finish line in our pumpkins.
Yeah.
We find the biggest pumpkin in the country, so big that it broke the scales and the British record. But could we change these giant fruits into lean, mean racing machines?
Hey, Zoe.
Hey, Korn.
I've got my pumpkin and the T-shirt, is it a Halloween thing?
Yeah, your detective skills are good in that one, but I have to tell you, as much as I love you, cute little pumpkin, it's too cute and it's too small, because in this challenge, we need bigger pumpkins. I'm talking massive, I'm talking, show her the pumpkins, guys!
Oh my word.
We are going to make these pumpkins into boats. Let's do paper, scissors, stones and see who gets paper, scissors, stones.
Yes, cool. In 1, 2, 3, which one?
I got to choose. Brilliant. Okay.
Have a concert.
Which one should I go for, Ian? Okay. I've consulted my team, and I am going for this one. Okay, Con, let's start making these into boats.
Treat her carefully.
After a bit of pushing and shoving, where even the camera crew got involved, it was time to get to work.
I cannot believe that I'm going to be sat in that and driving it. It's so weird.
I was thinking tactics.
We're going to chop the top off, and then we're going to put it on the water. So that is our tactic.
While I had a more hands-on approach.
Are you sure you've carved enough room for my bottom?
How can we fail with a diagram like that? And this definitely won't roll over in the water.
I hope not.
Okay, guys,
lift
it.
Wow.
So big. That is hilarious.
Wow. To give our pumpkins extra power, we were going to motorise them.
Outboard motor. Water. Shark. I never put the shark there.
And then my favourite bit.
I love it when we use the tools. Look, it's all coming together. It's looking beautiful.
I love my work. Really?
Fantastic. It's really starting to look like a boat and not a pumpkin, which is brilliant.
Do you know, I think that Connie's looks a bit like
a big toilet seat. And that's it is nearly 7 o'clock. We've been building our pumpkin boat for, well, nearly 7 hours now. And to think that in 12 hours' time, we're going to be at the shoreline launching these boats. Oh, we better get back to work.
What are we going to call these pumpkins?
Maybe something Halloween-y?
Trick or treat?
Yes.
Trick or treat, right. What do you want? Trick or treat.
Race day. A huge crowd had gathered. We were racing at Lymington River. The first run around their flag and back would be the winner. But first, some finishing touches.
Yay! It looks good.
So who would it be, trick or treat?
I think Zoe's going to win because she's got longer arms.
Go, Konnie!
I'm feeling a bit scared.
I'm feeling really confident because I'm so comfortable in my pumpkin. Make the best pumpkin win.
So here we are at the Lymington 2007 pumpkin boat race, and they are off. Oh dear, Zoe's gone off course. But I think Konnie may be joining her. Oh dear, Con. There's a handshake there. I'd save that for the end, girls, if I was you. Is going round in circles the smartest game plan?
Not very good at that, boys. What was that I was saying? Right, left, easy? Not really.
What is Konnie playing at? I think she may have dropped anchor.
I think I've lost. I can't get mine to move.
What's Konnie doing?
I'm sorry.
Well, I'm glad someone's seeing the funny side, but I've got a bus to catch.
Tell me now how to see it.
I'm so rubbish at the vertical, mate. At least we're both in the same boat.
We were getting nowhere, and as the tide was going out, sadly, we had to abandon our race.
Or even ever finishing the race. It's just about getting in the pumpkin and having a go, and we certainly had a go. But you know what? I have to say, I think it's been the first challenge I've ever failed. What about you, Con?
Oh my gosh, it's one of many.
High five. Well done, Con.
I still think we did well.
Oh my gosh, that was so funny. The whole town had turned out, hadn't they, to watch this big race, and it had been advertised in the local paper, and then we just went round and round in circles. It was so embarrassing. But good fun.
Yeah, good fun.
Good fun.
But speaking of failing challenges, I hope I don't fail this one.
Zoe, you are so going to be in the zone and successful. We have every faith in you.
Right, Martin, let's just check the temperature before we start, yeah?
Okay, by all
means. Do you want to put it in?
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay.
Tense moment. As we check what the temperature is.
Hope it's nice and cool.
Here we go.
I think we may have taken it off the scale. Yeah.
Okay, it's literally off the scale.
It's safe to say it's very hot.
This is hot.
I can
feel that it's hot.
Good luck, Zoe.
Okay, well, Zoe, we're all supporting you. Your supporters are filling the garden. So in your own time,
shall
team.
Shall I put some marshmallows between my toes?
Maybe
okay,
not.
Okay, my team.
Okay. The tiger.
Come on, Zoe.
Yeah.
What's your name?
Zoe.
Are you ready?
Yes.
Show me.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh!
Yes, absolutely.
How are feet? How are
feet? Superbly done.
Let me check my feet.
Perfect.
They're a bit
absolutely
dirty. Perfect. You know, they're not burnt, which is the main thing.
What
didn't even feel any heat? What do you remember? Can you remember anything?
I remember counting.
Would you like to see the moment for yourself?
Can we have an action
replay? Okay, let's have an action replay. I think so. There you are. Oh, my
God. Oh, hot feet so action.
So impressive.
Brilliant.
So impressive.
Well done.
She obviously did well, didn't she?
She did fantastic. We have a certificate for you to commemorate the moment.
Thank you.
Please always remember us when you look at that. Well done. Absolutely.
Very much for coming, Martin.
Our pleasure. Thank you for your dedication and time.
Oh, no worries. And don't forget, Zoe was in the zone and professionally trained. Whatever you do, do not try that at home. But whatever you do, have a happy and safe Halloween.
For sure.
Happy Halloween. See ya. Happy Halloween.
Next time on Blue Peter, I swap places with one of the children you'll be helping for the brand new Blue Peter appeal.
And-
friends, if you're watching us on BBC One, get online right now to talk to Zoe on the web straight after the show. Zoe, you did so well.
Oh, thanks, Konnie.
That's amazing.
Get on, Konnie and Zoe Firewalkers.
Yeah.
We are today.